Hello, everybody. It's great to be able to gather around God's Word again. And we do all hope that very soon we'll be able together to come to the church again and worship God collectively as we meet together in this place. I greet you in God's name. Grace and peace to you from the one who is, who always was, and who is still to come, from the sevenfold Spirit before his throne, and from Jesus Christ. He is the faithful witness to these things, the first to rise from the dead, and the ruler of all the kings of the world. Let us sing Beneath the Southern Cross. Now let's listen to the Word of God as we find it in the first book of Peter, chapter 1, and verses 3-9. All praise to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is by his great mercy that we have been born again, because God raised Jesus Christ from the dead. Now we live with great expectation, and we have a priceless inheritance, an inheritance that is kept in heaven for you, pure and undefiled, beyond the reach of change and decay. And through your faith, God is protecting you by his power until you receive this salvation, which is ready to be revealed on the last day for all to see. So be truly glad. There is wonderful joy ahead, even though you must endure many trials for a little while. These trials will show that your faith is genuine. It is being tested as fire tests and purifies gold, though your faith is far more precious than mere gold. So when your faith remains strong through many trials, it will bring you much praise and glory and honor on the day when Jesus Christ is revealed to the whole world. You love him, even though you have never seen him. Though you do not see him now, you trust him, and you rejoice with a glorious, inexpressible joy. The reward for trusting him will be the salvation of your souls. In a MasterCard ad, a young boy helps his dad to save water by an electricity saving bulb, and also using or buying a recyclable or a reusable bag. Helping your dad become a better man, priceless, the young boy says. Being given a new life by God because Jesus Christ rose from the grave, priceless, absolutely priceless. And this priceless inheritance is as safe as can be. It is described in verse 4 as an inheritance that is kept in heaven for you, pure and undefiled, beyond the reach of change and decay. The fact that we have new life and life everlasting is beyond the reach of change and decay. Doesn't that give you a warm feeling of confidence? We should therefore guard against thoughts that we are not good enough, or to interpret circumstances as proof that God perhaps does not love us. Note the reason or merit on which we receive the priceless inheritance. In verse 3 we read, "All praise to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is by his great mercy that we have been born again, because God raised Jesus Christ from the dead." We do not deserve it. We did not earn it. It is by God's great mercy and through God's immeasurable love that we receive the right to be God's children. We are God's people because of Jesus' death and resurrection, not because we made the cut and was good enough. This is big, and we often struggle to get our heads and our hearts around the fact that we were given something priceless for free. It is in stark contrast with our perception that there is no such thing as a free lunch. We must also remember that this is not a lotto win. We are not randomly lucky to have won this big prize. This priceless inheritance is there for everybody. Everybody who responds to God's invitation to come to him and accept the gift Jesus Christ earned by dying on the cross and by raising from death. In Romans 6, verse 23, we read, "For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord." That's all well and good. We were made new and we were reconciled with God and all that. But I know I'm not perfect. And I know none of us are perfect. Because we are not perfect, we sometimes make the huge mistake to reason. Because I'm fallible and all too human, making mistakes every day, it might mean that I do not really possess the priceless inheritance. We start to doubt because we can relate to Paul saying in Romans 7:19, "I want to do what is good, but I don't. I don't want to do what is wrong, but I do it anyway." We start to doubt our salvation because we are not perfect. Because it's a daily struggle to live in a God-honoring and God-glorifying way. That is why God gave us the comfort and encouragement of verse 5. "And through your faith, God is protecting you by his power until you receive this salvation, which is ready to be revealed on the last day for all to see." Let's note clearly, it does not read, "and through your perfect life and the great choices you make every day." It reads, "and through your faith." Through our faith, God protects us by his power. How wonderful is that? So be truly glad. There is a wonderful joy awaiting you. But perhaps this is a catch. Although you may have to experience all kinds of trials, suffering, and grief for a little while. No, this is not a catch. Most scholars agree that our text primarily refers to persecution because of faith in verse 6 and verse 7 of the passage we read. It is about Christians experiencing pushback and ridicule because they believe. Christians being denied good jobs because of their faith. Christians intimidated and harassed because of their faith. Christians incarcerated, tortured, and killed because they believe in God and that Jesus Christ died for them and rose from the grave. That is happening every day in many places around the world. But Christians experiencing persecution in whatever form, know this, God is protecting you by his power until you will be vindicated on the last day. And these trials will purify and strengthen your faith, like the process gold must undergo to be purified. Suffering Christians, don't lose hope. Don't lose faith. God is with you and will carry you. Although persecution is primarily referenced here, I believe we can also apply this encouragement to everyday trials and tribulations. Stand firm and hold fast to your faith if you are currently experiencing tough times. If COVID-19 is greatly impacting on your happiness and peace of mind, stand firm and know that God is protecting you. If you are worried about providing for yourself and your family in weeks and months to come, hold on to your faith and the knowledge that God is protecting you and will be with you. Sometimes our struggles are health related or about strained and broken relationships. Whatever the case may be, believe that God is protecting you and that you will never lose what is truly priceless, your inheritance from God. What does this faith we need to hold on to look like? According to our passage, it is about loving Jesus Christ even though we have never seen him. It is about trusting Him, even though we can't see Him now. And it is about rejoicing with a glorious, inexpressible joy, despite our imperfection and despite the imperfection of the world we live in. Will you perhaps say aloud, or let's call it confess, the following? I'll hold up the words in a minute. I love God even though I've never seen God. I trust God even though I cannot see God now. Because I believe, because I love and trust God, I rejoice and live with hope, thanksgiving and praise. To God be all glory and honor. Amen. If you would like to say that with me, I will hold this up and hopefully you'll be able to see that. Yep, there we go. Let's together confess. I love God, even though I've never seen God. I trust God, even though I cannot see God now. Because I believe, because I love and trust God, I rejoice and live with hope, thanksgiving and praise. To God be all glory and honor. Amen. It is great to, as a congregation, say those words together. Let's sing an old favorite now, How Great Thou Art.
I see the stars, I hear the mighty thunder.
Let us pray. Lord, with deep-seated gratitude and with a sense of complete dependence on you, we approach you in prayer. Almighty God, we need you. We need you to remind us of our priceless inheritance we have. We need you, Holy Spirit, to help us accept our inheritance and rejoice in it. Thank you, Lord, for protecting us with your power. Together we pray that the body of Christ will take what we have learned during COVID-19 alert level 4 and take the good of that into the future. We pray that churches experiencing financial stress at this time find a way forward. We pray that individuals and families be able to deal with the emotional, spiritual, relational and financial impacts of the COVID-19 era. We pray, Lord, that more people in New Zealand and around the world will become aware and also engage with you, our gracious and loving God. We pray that society and business will transition well and responsibly into alert level 3 on Thursday. We pray, Lord, that New Zealand will soon be COVID-19 free. Be with every person, every family impacted by this situation. Be with each one of us, we pray, Lord. And we deeply thank you for our faith family and pray that you will be with each and every one of us. Carry us, help us grow and nurture our faith. Help us hold on to our faith. And Lord, thank you. Thank you again for our priceless inheritance. Amen. Let's end this service by singing together a benediction. May God be with you in a very real and a very loving way, especially if you are facing tough times. But give him glory and praise if all is well. Until next time.